Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm super pumped for today's video, so let's get right into this. If you are on YouTube and have watched any video, then you probably have already seen at least one or two or even more of these Skillshare ads that a lot of fellow content creators do here on YouTube. They are all very similar and they all use the same wording, which has always kind of put me off from testing Skillshare and has always made it seem kind of sketchy to me. I don't know. Yeah, if you don't know what Skillshare is, it's a learning platform that is similar to YouTube but more focused on learning. YouTube is more focused on entertainment, I feel like, but on Skillshare it's all about learning and sharing skills. Professionals teach things they are good at. You get these classes that have different parts that focus on different aspects of a certain topic, and then in the end you also get a task to complete and share with the community and with the teacher, and you can get feedback on the work that you have created using the class. And you can also download additional features that the teacher has provided, which is really cool. So when someone approached me on Instagram about the ambassador program for Skillshare, I thought, well, this may be the perfect opportunity for me to get into this and try this myself. And the ambassador program means that I also get a few free months, but also that I get a link that I can share with you guys to also try it out. And if you use my link, you get 2 months of Skillshare for free, and I also get a small kickback from each person who has signed up, which is a great way to support my channel and to support me, because I'm not sponsored by Skillshare. I'm just doing this to entertain you guys and just to have fun for this week. Okay, now let's get into the video. My plan was to watch one class a day every day for a week, and I didn't want to challenge myself to do the exact task that was mentioned in the video, but I did want to do it for the ones that I felt like I wanted to, but also I wanted to challenge myself to incorporate at least a few of the things I've learned into artwork that I was making that day, or even maybe in drawings I would be making in the future. I decided to do this over the course of a week, so I would get enough time between each class to do the task or incorporate the things I've learned and to kind of let them sit in my mind, and then also so I could try 7 different classes to kind of get a good overview on how they are and to see different kinds of classes. I did mainly focus on illustration-based stuff, since that's what I'm most interested in and that's something I wanted to learn something about. But there are also a lot of classes about photography and, as I said, being self-employed, being on Instagram, and so on and so on. The first class I did was character illustration, drawing faces, figures, and clothing by Gabriel Piccolo. And if you don't know, Gabriel Piccolo is an amazing illustrator and someone I've been following online since forever. And this is the first thing I noticed about Skillshare that I really enjoyed, and that's that there are a lot of very famous and very good artists that don't really post stuff like this to other platforms, who don't have YouTube channels or stuff like that. But a lot of them do have a Skillshare video, so it's really cool to see them talk and see them explain things in video format and to see their process, and that's something I really enjoyed about this week, because I followed a lot of my favorite artists and watched a few of them create something for Skillshare. And the classes are very well done, as I said, so you really get a good glimpse into their personality and into their process, which is really cool. His video was a very conceptual video about drawing characters, and he also got a lot into drawing facial expressions and how to make them more varied but also very believable. And that's actually something that tied into my past Cubemba drawings very well, where I was focusing on drawing facial expressions and really getting into that topic. So I really liked seeing him talk about this topic as well and explain it from his perspective. So yeah, I really enjoy just watching him create something. I didn't really follow his steps or anything. I just enjoyed watching him. It was very soothing for me, and yeah, a really, really great class, and I can recommend to anyone who is interested in him or is very interested in very cartoony styles and how to make your illustrations look very magical and cool. The second class I did was Level Up Your Portrait Drawings by Chris Hong, and this class I'm very passionate about. I want more people to watch this and more people to see this because Chris Hong is one of my favorite illustrators ever, and she also has a YouTube channel, so that's really cool. But she did a Skillshare video where she just talked about how to draw pencil portraits, and which are one of my favorite things that she does, so I definitely needed to watch that. And she talks about making preparation work for your illustrations, so grouping the lights and shadows into different grouping the lights and shadows before you start the illustration, or grouping them in your head, or she even taught how to do it in Photoshop to prepare for the illustration and then making the portrait, having that knowledge. It really changed the way I approach portraits, and also I had a lot of fun just watching her explain. She explains everything very simply and easily to understand, but still talks about stuff that I haven't even thought about or that I hadn't heard anyone else talk about, which was very exciting for me. And I learned so much during this class, so I can really recommend it if you want to try one of the classes in my video. Yeah, she explains everything in detail, but very, you can easily understand what she's talking about, and it's not boring or anything. The class just flows, and in the end she also has, I think, an hour and a half or something of footage of her drawing a portrait in real time, which is really cool. And also while she's teaching the class, you get real time footage and just her showing what she's explaining, which is really cool, and her drawing along while she's talking. So I can definitely recommend this class, and I of course felt immediately inspired to also create something, also draw a few portraits. And this class just really got my creative juices flowing, and it just blew my mind. So then I also watched a class on painting light and shadow by Gabrielle Bricky, and she was more information heavy, and I did have to take a few breaks during the class to just kind of let it sit and digest the information. But I liked how deep she got into everything and how well she explained how certain light situations come and happen, and how different colors affect each other and how that affects your illustration. And then also how to draw a character in a darker lighting, lit from below or something like that. I didn't learn too much, but I felt like the knowledge I already had got more dense, and I learned new terms and learned explanations for what I knew would happen, but I didn't really know why, and she explained that. And it's a very good class for people who maybe are not sure about light and shadow yet and want to really learn the fundamentals and really want to get a good foundation on drawing those. So I can also really recommend that class. The next class I watched was the Color Master class by Victor Ngai, and I just love this one. It was the perfect combination of information, very good information, but then also just great humor. And she talks about how to steal color palettes from other artists, but before she really gets into that, she first covers all the fundamentals and explains how to use color, how color affects each other, how to use contrast in combination with color to really bring your illustrations to the next level. And then also every now and again she just makes a pun, and she's just super funny, and it just lights up the entire class. And you can see her thought process behind coloring one of her paintings, which is really cool. She shows you all the steps that she does and what she's thinking while she's doing the steps. And it's very educational, but also super funny. And she also talks about stuff that I have only heard in the art school I go to. I haven't really seen a lot of YouTubers talk about exporting your file and setting the file up right, about Adobe RGB and sRGB and those kind of things. She really gets into those and also explains them very easily in a way that I've only seen my teachers in art school talk about. So I really like seeing that and seeing those areas also being covered for people who maybe are not going to art school, but also really want to get all the information that you actually need, and not just how to create certain effects, but also the fundamentals that are important to be an illustrator. The next class was character illustration with Photoshop and watercolor by Cosmic Spectrum, and behind me is actually her comic. I'm a huge fan of her, and again, this just showed how in Skillshare you can watch your favorite creators in beautiful light situations and just see them work and see their characters, see how they talk, see how they explain stuff. And I also felt very inspired to bring out my paints and paint something myself along. This video wasn't too educational, but more showed her process and how she approaches her illustrations, and it was very interesting to see because it's not the typical process that you see on YouTube every artist do, but just with a few different twists, which I really enjoyed. And yeah, it really made me want to also create something and made me feel very inspired and made me want to, yeah, just draw along. And it was a great kind of break from all the very information heavy stuff to just watching something alongside while making the same steps and yeah, creating something at the same time. The next class that I watched was digital illustration by Lord Grease, which is also one of my favorite illustrators on Instagram. She makes very beautiful portraits and has a very interesting style, and it was very interesting to see her process because she actually sketches on top of photographs to create her portraits, which is something I haven't really tried myself or seen a lot, so that was interesting to see. Again, her class for me mostly was about seeing her process, not the information that she covered, because I already knew most of that stuff, but it was cool to see her steps and how she does everything. And she also had a few cool effects that I personally then tried out in commissions I was working on at that time, and I really liked them. For example, she shows how to make hair glow or some subtle color effects to make your illustration more interesting. If you want to see those, you just have to check out her class and you will see what I mean. And very interesting, very cool to see, and yeah, just cool to see her create something that you usually just see on Instagram. I then watched a class by Elizabeth Owen, which I didn't know before, and it was about designing and creating repeat patterns in Illustrator. And I personally have only made a few very basic patterns before, so I was very interested and yeah, wanted to get into this. The first classes I took were more about just seeing my favorite creators in their process, but then I got a bit bored of that and then wanted to really learn something and use Skillshare to, yeah, learn a new skill. Hi Mila! Yeah, I watched that class and it was about coming up with an idea for a pattern and then creating the different elements that make up the pattern, and then yeah, how to make it repeat in a way that it looks really nice. And of course, because I'm currently on my Alice in Wonderland trip, I created an Alice in Wonderland themed pattern, and I really liked the class. And again, Elizabeth also covers fundamentals and shows how to set up the file and how to export the file if you are working with clients, and how to set up the pattern to actually make it work and so it would repeat itself properly. And yeah, I love the pattern that I created, and I now really want to experiment more with creating patterns, and yeah, want to make more. And it was a very inspiring and educational class, and I'm super happy that I took it. So I now know how to do patterns, and I will be using this more for artwork in the future, I guess. Now, today is Sunday, the last day of the challenge, and I also took a class this morning, and it was Isometric Design for Beginners by Hayden Alp, and I hope I did pronounce it correctly, but yeah, it's about the basics of doing isometric design, and something I've always wanted to get into, but I didn't really know how to make the grid properly and stuff, and he just covers all those basics and then also provides downloadable shortcuts for Adobe Illustrator, which is again a really cool feature of Skillshare, that down below there is a downloadable section where you can download resources that the teacher provides, and that will make the class even more dense and great for you, because you get the resource as well, which is not possible in YouTube, and which I have found to be very helpful. You not only get to share what you've done with the teacher and the class, but also get additional stuff that usually would be provided through Patreon or stuff before, or what I've seen before. I haven't gotten too far yet with the drawing. Here is what I've created so far. I wanted to do an isometric illustration of Alice being in the house and kind of being crammed in there because she's so big, but I haven't gotten too far yet. But I still want to finish this and want to learn more and improve my isometric designs. But that's where I'm so far. Okay, now that the week is over, what is my conclusion? Honestly, I'm surprised about how much I've learned this week, and I'm positively surprised by Skillshare. I've always been kind of on the fence, and I've been like, yeah, but you can still get these informational videos on YouTube. They are harder to find here on YouTube because it's more about entertainment and doing fun art stuff. And then on Skillshare, it's really more about learning something and developing and more about teaching. You can really see the difference in videos. For YouTube, it's more about quantity and being entertaining, and in Skillshare it's more about quality and really creating something that's valuable to the students and really teaching something to the students, which I've really enjoyed, and my brain has been stimulated in a different way, which was very, very nice for a change. I do still like watching super long 50-minute vlogs of Joycen just rambling around and showing her life, but I also like the change where I've been learning new things and learning practical information that will bring me further in my career. As I said, there are similar channels on YouTube that provide similar type of information, and I would love if we could just come together as a community and share those channels down below. I'm thinking like Proko, for example, who also does very educational stuff, which brings people forward, and let's share some of those down below if you guys want. So can I recommend Skillshare, and will I continue my subscription once my 3 months have expired, and will I pay for the service, or would I pay for the service? At the beginning of the week I would have said probably no, but now I would say yes. And actually, I really want to continue the subscription, and I actually want to challenge myself to continue learning stuff more regularly. Not every day, but I think at least 2 classes where I really learn something a week. But I think that's going to be my New Year's resolution, to really learn something new 2 times a week. And there are also videos like, for example, growing on social media or stuff that you could listen to while you work and just have it kind of like an educational audiobook on. And those I also want to watch, but I also really want to focus on 2 things that I am learning new. For example, I really want to get into animation and really properly learn how to do it, and start making small animations for my Instagram and also for you guys. And I also want to look at more videos about being a shop owner and having your own Etsy store. I think there are a lot of things I don't know yet and that I could learn to improve my life and my Etsy shop. So I'm also super excited to get into that as well. I can 100% recommend this site to anyone who just wants to learn something, to level up their skills, and to anyone who wants to be stimulated differently than just watching fun videos, and to anyone who wants to take their skills to a more professional level. As I said, I've really noticed how these videos on Skillshare cover the topic better and in a more professional way. So I can recommend, if you maybe don't have access to going to an art school but still want to get the same level of education, I've really felt like the way the topics are covered maybe is even better than art school, because you can watch the classes over and over again, and then also they are very dense and very simply made but still very easy to understand. So yeah, I can highly recommend that if you want to learn something new and level up your skills. Also, you can't really beat the features of being able to share your drawings with the class and also with the teacher. You can see what other people made and you can get feedback on your work, which is again very similar to art school and something you just can't get with YouTube. And you can easily find the videos that you need just by searching them, and they are all perfectly curated for you and they all are very high in quality, and it's easy to find something that you actually can take the information from. I know this has been a very long and very information dense video, but if you want to try Skillshare yourself and see if it's something for you, I can highly recommend it. I was on the fence, but now I actually really like the site, and you can also save your classes to different folders of certain things you want to learn. So I've been making some folders about things I want to learn, especially animation. So if you want to learn something yourself and want to try Skillshare, please use my link. It helps me a lot and helps this channel and also helps you, because you will be able to learn something. And if you are still watching, thank you so much. It really means a lot to me, and I hope you enjoyed this video. It's different from my usual stuff. But yeah, I will be seeing you very soon in my next video. Bye.